Now, in this video, I'm going to take a look at the starting of the water tube boiler. Okay. Now, so of course, at the beginning, the power will be off. So make sure you turn you see this switch, that is an on-off switch. You want to make sure this one is off. And go to side in here, the middle one, this one is going to be on menu. And the frame control, menu frame control got to be on a zero, really low, lower, before you can start up the, turn the power on. Now again, so on menu, at zero position on the frame control, and this thing, the on-off switch is supposed to be off, supposed to be off, and then you can take a look, you can turn on the power. Now let's go to the side in here. On the side in there, so that is a power switch in here. Right now it's locked, so you have to unlock it and turn it on. Okay. So that is a sequence before you start up the boiler. Okay. Now, so let's say if you turn the power on, and this one is called a boiler programmer. So the boiler programmer will go initiate. It might take probably a minute or half a minute to initiate. Now, when it's done, so if all the control is reset, everything is okay, you will be able to just flip the switch in here. You flip this switch, and then the programmer will go through the programming procedure and start the boiler. Okay. Now, let's take a look at the reset switch in this one. So on the programmer itself, you have the reset right there. Now, on the high limit pressure cutout, there's a reset there. And then on the fine control circuit in here, you have the another reset in here. So any one of these one, if they are not reset, and then you cannot start the boiler. Now let's say take a look at another reset switch on the gas line. Okay, let's go to the gas line there. Walk slowly to the gas line. Okay. Now, that is this one is a low gas pressure reset. The back button you can use this. And that's another reset. It's a high gas pressure reset right there. All those reset had to be okay. Had to be made before you can start the boiler.